Technology used in other countries to make buildings hurricane, tornado, fire, and bulletproof is now making its way over to the U.S.
West News' Megan Mulatto took a tour of a demo home being built in Kissimmee with materials you wouldn't expect.
Construction is underway on this demo home in Kissimmee. But it isn't being built with your typical materials. Instead, it's being built with panels.
Essentially, what the panels are is a polystyrene core and then double galvanized steel mesh on the outside. Then you finish the panels with shotcrete.
CEO and co-founder of Vero Building Systems, Annette Rubin, says millions of structures in other countries already use this technology for stadiums, to preschools, to sheds in people's backyards.
It's extremely versatile. It can even be used for seawalls, roadways, bridges, sidewalks.
The panels are light enough for me to pick up, but with the shotcrete lining, Ruben says they're strong enough to withstand a hurricane.
So it's very durable, very resistant to storms, fires. It's even bulletproof and blast resistant too.
You could call this your living area.
We took a tour through the demo home located at the very first plant in Florida. It's only the second plant in the U.S.
We started yesterday mid-morning, and today we'll wrap up the framing. Tomorrow we'll do the shotcrete.
Ryan Skelly with Skip Construction says the home only took about 24 hours to get to this point and should be wrapped up by the end of the week.
Definitely faster, without a doubt, quicker than if you're doing a block, like a cinder block build. Definitely faster than that.
We're told the technology also improves insulation, but Ruben says the most important aspect is its capability to protect.
We currently are in talks with a lot of different builders and developers for all types of projects. So bulletproof schools, hospitals where you don't have to evacuate your NICU and your ICU when a storm is coming. We foresee it expanding and being used for all different varieties of buildings.
In Kissimmee, Megan Mulatto, West 2 News.